Him. Let's get right into the action.
One way. Should we check out the bookstore before we leave?
Got a lock here.
I'll give it a whirl. All yours.
Brother, what Comstock failed to understand is that our contraption is a window not into prophecy, but probability. But his money means the Lutece Field could become the Lutece Tear, a window between worlds, a window through which you and I might finally be together.
So that's her brother.
You hold on to this.
Great.
I'm digging all the toys.
Check out downstairs. I heard you. Cut you in half.
Sally! The bastard snuck in while the Vox was shooting up the place and took my girl! Got her locked up in the salty oyster, his hidden closet he keeps all his treasures. Just need to hit the button under the register to open it, but...
Okay, I gotta go check out the bar. Okay,
these
so it might be downtown.
We won't be able to return.
Can you open this?
It's a simple dual dial lock. My book said most fools keep the combination no more than 20 feet away.
Let's hope we find one of those fools. This might be it. Why are you so keen on lockpicking and code breaking?
If you put a person in a cage, they develop an interest in such things.
I suppose so.
That's very true.
I won't be locked up again. Yeah, I'm officially spooked.
Elizabeth. Elizabeth, you...
Promise me.
I will stop him.
That is an oath you cannot keep. But promise me that if it comes to it, you will not let him take me back.
Come on, you're being a little dramatic.
It won't come to that. All right.
This is probably where we're gonna find the monster.
Look, Fox are tearing this place apart.
Gosh, that's what we look like. Okay, so that one's a hairpin lock. So we're not gonna open that one. We're gonna come over here first and open this one up. We might even get enough Silver Eagles in here.
Locked. Elizabeth?
Oh, this is a hairpin lock as well.
Back there at the shop. What you asked me to do.
Let's not discuss it.
No, what did that thing do to you?
If he were to take me back, that's death, Mr. DeWitt. Or something so like it, I cannot tell the difference.
Need some help with this.
Give me a second.
I am glad that the game doesn't make it run on the way back, though. Oh, so much lore. Feel too comfortable, you know, sharing its vision. Wait a minute, we already watched these. How did I almost miss that?
In mid-air. Colleagues called my Lutece field quantum levitation, but in fact it was nothing of the sort. Magicians levitate. My atom simply failed to fall. If an atom could be suspended indefinitely, well, why not an apple? If an apple, why not a city?
And that's how this place is born. Huh? Oh yeah, that's everywhere we gotta go. I just upgraded this too. Before I even had it, that's crazy.
Press to generate a magnetic shield. Hold to absorb damage and release to throw it back. Hold and release to create an explosive trap.
I think there's a lock.
That's crazy.
Hold on to this.
Of your finest wine, James. Consider this overdue. Oh, wait, wait.
Here you go. Salt, Booker.
Tonight, the Prophet moved against his political enemies. He preaches mercy, but 40 souls lie tonight dead in unmarked graves. If a man was ever unworthy of grace, who would be my husband? But when I was beyond redemption, he offered it anyway, can I deny forgiveness to one who with love granted it to me?
Wow.
Found some money. Take it.
That's pretty deep. I'm sure I have to pay really close attention here.
What a waste. How's the city going to come back from this?
Maybe it shouldn't. Elizabeth.
Really? That little old lock.
Yes, this little old lock.
It's done.
front of all the men, the sergeant looked at me and said, "Your family tree shelters a teepee or two, doesn't it, son?" This lie, this calumny, it followed me all my life. From that day, no man truly called me comrade. It was only when I burnt the teepees with the squaws inside that they take me as one of their own. Only blood can redeem blood.
Oh god, and that's where he went crazy.
Do it.
And that's the person all these people are worshiping.
You know, I keep thinking about that dream that you had. New York on fire. There's something about it.
Things are starting to line up.
Those pennants. Seems like the Vox have chosen their favorite color.
Seems about right.
Only 10 left.
Elizabeth?
On it. Got it.
Of apples.
Might lose their value, but gold always trades.
Bella had some. Hmm.
man died just like this and had a can of beans on him. There's a whole lot of stuff here. Looks like it's Lady Comstock right there. Remember from the little movies, the personal movies. Yeah, she's from one of those.
I now observe, well, then you are to be the Mozart of Columbia.
Girls just want to have fun. It's not much of a hit, huh?
You hold on to this.
Whenever I hear Elizabeth start saying something, I just start tapping square.
Thank you.
Did I check over here?
Looks abandoned.
Booker, there's a lockpick over there.
I'm so glad that she tells me. I'm not sure if I'm even heading the right way.
This one open?
Give me a second. Done.
Just what the doctor ordered.
Want to hold on to this? A code book. I the cipher is.
Can you help me out with this lock?
On it. Got it.
Locked.
Keep a lookout. Done.
Your boy's a little lost.
Beyond that gate lies Comstock House.
This is for the miracle child. Hello. I'm sorry your mother, Lady Comstock, is dead. I think she is altogether better than mine. Since you live there, can you tell me why the tower has been closed? People say it's poor weather, then the pox, then a haunting. If it is a secret, I promise not to tell a soul. Your pen friend, Constance.
Lady Comstock, how lovely to see you. Wonderful of you to make the journey, especially considering your painful death 19 years ago.
Lady Comstock?
The dress. The thing has mistaken me for my mother.
Your fingerprints do not seem to be your own today, Lady Comstock. Are you unwell?
This isn't going to work.
I think it can.
Your mother's dead, Elizabeth.
Yes. I think it's time I paid my respects. Let's head to where she's buried.
Looks like I'm about to become a handyman. I'm gonna have to lend Elizabeth a hand.
There's the grave. My mother's buried.
Where are you
going? It's a good thing we've already explored.
What are we looking for?
Star she blows.
There you go.
It's your mother's grave.
They have her preserved in an airtight chamber. Her fingerprints will get us into Comstock House.
She's your mother.
The mother who abandons their child doesn't draw a lot of sympathy in my book.
Take a moment to think about what you're doing.
There. Will you open the door, or do I have to go in without you?
Will she actually go in without me?
Elizabeth, why is your mother a ghost?
She's not. He used me to power that device. He opened up some kind of tear.
Alive or dead?
Why do you ask what?
When the delicious question is when.
The only difference between past and present
is semantics.
Lives, lived, will live.
Dies, died, will die.
If we could perceive time as it truly was,
what reason would grammar professors have to get out of bed?
Like us all, Lady Comstock exists across time.
She's both alive and dead.
She perceives being both.
She finds this condition disagreeable.
Perception without comprehension
is a dangerous combination.
Look! Footsteps.
She goes to unfinished business.
We have to follow her. Convince her to open the gate to Comstock House.
It's a shame you have need of her to enter Comstock House.
Frankly, she doesn't seem all that cooperative.
There is a way to bring her to reason.
Three truths you must discover first.
Truths which, in this world, Comstock has destroyed.
If only one of you had the power to alter time and space.
That would be a blessing, wouldn't it?
Hmm.
Well, you're sarcastic.
There's something off about Lady Comstock.
Yeah. I noticed.
No, you don't understand. She doesn't belong here. I brought something through. I'm not so sure it was her.
Show yourself!
After him!
Wait.
locked.
Sure thing. It's done.
Stock has sabotaged our contraption. Yet, we are not dead. A theory. We are scattered amongst the possibility space. But my brother and I are together, and so I'm content. He is not. The business with the girl lies unresolved. But perhaps there is one who can finish it in our stead.
So that's why they chose me.
Feel better already.
I just got an achievement, infused with greatness. Also, that's really cool to learn why they're everywhere in all those places at once.
Seems to have been made sterile by simple exposure to our contraption. A theory. Just as sexual reproduction can de-emphasize the traits of each parent, so goes the effect of multiple realities on our own. Your traits dissipate until they become unrecognizable or cease to exist.
So it goes in both directions.
My sexual interest in your dear prophet is non-existent.
And Madame Lutess.
Furthermore, the man is quite sterile.
It's a lie. Come here, you little bastard! I want her out of my house!
Sterile.
They were my parents.
Then what were you to them?
She held it. They decided to imprison me. She deserved whatever Comstock did to her.
Seems to believe the child is a result of some errant act of carnality.
What did you mean before when you said Lady Comstock didn't belong here?
She's almost feral. It's like she's a reflection. I don't know.
A reflection of how you view your mother, maybe?
Lady Comstock seems to believe the child is a result of some errant act of carnality between myself and her beloved prophet. I told the poor woman the truth, that the child was a product of our little contraption, but I think she found that less believable than her delusion.
So, Elizabeth was made from the lettuce... research, I guess.
Found some money.
Christ!
Right up your alley.
Let me have a look. All done.